So a 2.5-year-old who was born with HIV is apparently cured from the disease, or the virus, I should say. After the baby was born, doctors gave the little girl very aggressive antiviral drugs, and now 2.5 years later, when they test her for HIV, they're finding that, okay, we're only seeing some trace material. However, it's basically not anything that can actually turn into AIDS. It's not considered HIV. It's just trace genetic material.
It's a huge potential breakthrough. I mean, this is, there was always, not always a way, it didn't always work, but there was an effort made when a mother was HIV positive, the drugs in the last, I don't know, 10 so years, 15 years maybe, that you could give to her would prevent the virus from being given to the unborn child.
Right.
But it didn't always work. But here, this baby didn't get it, and that they were able to do this is it's potentially a really significant breakthrough.
So a few more interesting details about this story. As Ben mentioned, a lot of times, if a woman has been diagnosed with HIV, she can get prenatal treatment that could prevent the fetus from getting the virus. However, in this case, doctors didn't know that she was positive for HIV because she was from a rural part of Mississippi, and they didn't test her. She didn't get any prenatal care, and they didn't test her until she went into labor, and then they discovered, oh my gosh, she has HIV, and this baby is going to be born with HIV. So literally 30 hours after the baby was born, they start treating her with 3 different types of antiviral treatments, and that's actually unheard of. It's a very aggressive form of treatment, and they don't typically do that with babies. But as I mentioned, you know, they notice that this virus is no longer in her. She's no longer HIV positive. However, they're thinking that there is a possibility that it could be dormant. So they have to wait a little longer before they can say, yes, we have actually cured her from HIV.
Potentially great story. Potentially great
story. Yeah, it is potentially great. I mean, what I would also love to see, of course, my mind went straight to, you know, well, what does this mean for adults and curing this in adults? And I still don't feel like there is an urgency, because prescription drug companies make so much money because people have to stay on these AIDS drugs. Mm-hmm. They're so expensive. They have to stay on them for their entire life. So for me, I look at this and I go, this is an amazing story. It potentially could be so great. How can we take what we know now and use it to help cure people who are adults with AIDS?
Yeah, I mean, I definitely get worried about the pharmaceutical companies and them potentially trying to stop researchers from finding a cure. However, there was one other individual 5 years ago in San Francisco. His name was Timothy Ray Brown. He had HIV, and they gave him a bone marrow transplant. And 5 years later, he stopped taking any type of drug, and they noticed that he no longer has HIV. Now, again, who knows? This is obviously very, very in its early stages. This type of treatment is in its early stages, so it wouldn't be that unheard of that they test him years down the line and they find out, oh, you know, it came back.
Yeah, and the bone marrow transplant came from someone who, it was like a very small percentage of people who did not carry the virus, who was unable to carry the virus.
Yeah, someone who was actually resistant to HIV, which is amazing. Highly evolved
I don't share, that is a, that, that's a, that that's amazing all by itself, especially for somebody like me who doesn't understand any of this stuff. but I do not share either of your cynicism about pharmaceutical companies. I do in general, and they make a tremendous amount of money, and it is easy to look at that and see that the cocktail that people living with HIV have to be on for the rest of their lives unquestionably makes a lot of money. The idea that that would squelch research into a cure, I'm not prepared to believe without evidence. Pharmaceutical companies have it rigged in this system that we have in our current healthcare system. They're gonna make a ton of money, whether we cure HIV, whether we cure AIDS or not. And I would hate to think it. I know you guys would too, that there was any effort to prevent coming up with a cure just because it suited companies.
I don't necessarily think it would be prevention. I look at the urgency of it. Is there an urgency? Is there a big incentive to really, really put a lot of money into?
Well, you've got to hope that the people would, I'm sorry, real quick, just to finish up my point, that the people at NIH and that researchers, that scientists who aren't motivated by the same things that the companies are at it as aggressively as they were 30 years ago.
Yeah, and currently worldwide there are about 300,000 mm-hmm. babies that are born with HIV. I mean, it is a serious problem. And of course, you know, there are certain things that are being done in other countries to try to prevent it, especially with prenatal care. But yeah, I mean, I would love to see a cure. I'm glad that researchers are fighting for this. And, you know, we'll keep you guys updated on this baby.
That woman was not born in, you know, you didn't say, you didn't finish it in a rural village in Kenya. She was born in the United States of America.
Mississippi.
And the fact that this girl didn't know she was HIV positive, had never been tested for it because she didn't have access to really good prenatal care. I mean, that's literally why we're trying to have healthcare reform in this country. And if you're against it, you're on the wrong side of history.